When you shoot your videos with high FPS and slow them down, you won't have any problems. For example, if you use a video shot at 120 frames per second with 30 FPS, you will get the slow motion effect properly. There is no problem so far. However, when you shoot with 30 FPS and when you want to play the video, you shot with 24 FPS, like slow motion, that is, when you want to slow it down, the video will look like it is stuttering and the fluidity of the video will be disrupted. In this tutorial, we eliminate this stuttering issue that occurs when you slow down videos in both Adobe Premiere and Adobe After Effects. I open Adobe Premiere and drag the video that we want to slow down onto the scene. This video is normally like this, and as you can see here, it was shot at 25 frames per second. And we will use this video in slow motion. When you are using it in slow motion, if you are into video, you know that when you slow down a 25 frame video, you will see stuttering in this video. I right click on the video, I select speed duration, because we are going to slow it down. This is where we specify how much we want to slow it down. If we do 50%, we slow it down twice. If we do 25%, we slow it down 4 times. We have a 2 second video and I say let's slow it down by 25% to complete it to 8 seconds. I've changed it to 25% and I click OK. And when we click OK, the 2 second video here, as you can see, has gone up to 8 seconds. And when I play it, I get the following result. Notice the stutter. There is a stutter here, because we are not playing a video that was shot at high frames per second. We are playing on a video shot at 25 frames per second. Therefore, when we slow down this video, we can see stuttering. Now, I'm going to show you how to make these stutters invisible and how to make the video play smoothly. Again, I right click on the video and select speed duration again. When I select this option, there is a point that we have just overlooked and we didn't even go there. And that's here, time interpolation option. I click on this option and select optical flow. We have already slowed it down by 25%. When I click on the OK button, you might not notice anything right now, because first of all, I need to take a preview render of the video for this optical flow feature to be active. For that, I press Enter on the keyboard. The rendering is done successfully. We can tell that the rendering is complete by the fact that the red stripe, the red line here is green, and the part with this clip is rendered. I'm going to show you what it looks like. I'm pressing the space key and watch this video again. As you can see, the stuttering that you just saw is now gone. Let's remember again what just happened. I undo the optical flow operation. And with the editing we have done, this is what the video looks like. It is almost as clean as a slow motion video. This is the slowdown process in Premiere. Now, let's move to After Effects and see how this slowing down process is done in After Effects. There are not independent topics. I wanted to include both programs in the same video, thinking that those who use Premiere and After Effects can switch between these two programs. Let me show you how to do the same in After Effects. Here is how to slow down a video in After Effects. First of all, I select the video I want to slow down. I go to Layer and under the Time option under Layer, I select the Time Stretch option. When I select this, you will see a screen like this. You specify how much you want to stretch it here, rather than in Premiere. When we set slow it down by 50%, it doubled it. With the logic in Premiere, when you want to slow it down by 50%, we make this option 200. So, we can say that in Premiere we divide, here we multiply. When I select this as 200, it goes from a 2 second video at 100 to a 4 second video when I play it at 200%. I exaggerate it a little more and set it to 400%. I press the OK button. And as you can see, it slowed down from 2 seconds to 8 seconds. The normal video was 2 seconds. When we slowed it down, it got to the 8 seconds. When we play it back, we see the following result. Of course, 400% is a very high number compared to a normal video. But let's see how it can be done here. I'll show you. Again, with the video selected, I go under Layer. Under the Frame Blending option, I select the Pixel Motion option. I click on that. I render my video first. After preview rendering with the 0 key on the keyboard, I play it with the space key. Let's see how the slow motion effect looks after rendering. As you can see, although 25% is a large percentage, we managed to get a video that looks like it was shot in slow motion. So here, The slowing down process worked successfully, thanks to the pixel motion feature. In this Adobe Premiere and Adobe After Effects tutorial, I showed how a video that was not shot with high FPS, but rather a video shot in a low format with low FPS, where you can see what the FPS is, how a video shot with a low rate can be slowed down smoothly through After Effects and Premiere, how it can be played without stuttering. You can create smoother videos in your slowed down videos using these methods. That's all for this video. I hope it was useful. If today's video was useful to you, don't forget to subscribe to my YouTube channel right now. Just click on the subscribe button below this video. Thank you for watching.